method of least squares, you can write along with me, because it is exactly same what we did in regression. Just remember and repeat, x will be replaced
with p.
Remaining everything will remain same. Don't repeat that. Okay, x, wherever we add in the regression formulas, that x will be replaced with
p.
Because here you don't have x variable. Here we have the time period p. Yesterday we studied how to find that p. First year 1, second year 2, that equal to 3, 4, 5, 8, 9. So instead of x, here the independent variable is always time. X will be replaced with p. Everything else remains same. So let us write it down and you can write it along with me. Method of least squares. No one should be talking. Now, as in regression we used to write, regression line of y on x is given by, here you won't write regression line, here you write equation of trend line. Equation of trend line is given by it. So exactly similar procedure, okay, like we used to write regression line of y on x is given by, here you write equation of trend line is given by y cap equals to a plus bt. Instead of x we will write, as I told you in the beginning, throughout the formulas, x will be replaced with t. Any confusion so far? Okay. Where b equals to, now here b equals to b1. Don't write b by t. Because in regression, we actually have two lines. I told you in the beginning of the period of regression. You have y on x also and x on y also, but in your syllabus, you had only y on x. So we have two b's, b by x, b x y. But here there is nothing like two equations of trend line. So b will always be b by t, we don't have to write that. B is simply b. One more thing. What did the b indicate in regression?
Slope
and what else? Regression coefficient and what else? Change in y due to? You did change in x. Here b will indicate change in y. But what's the unit change in t? If t is expressed in years, then b indicates yearly change in y. If time period is in months, then b indicates monthly change in y. If time period is in weeks, then b indicates weekly change in y. And if time period is in days, daily change in y. This is the meaning of b. Understood that? Either yearly change in y or monthly change in y or weekly change in y or daily change in y. Any confusion so far? And how many formulas were in regression?
Seven.
We had done that eliminated formula also at the end. So how many formulas we had?
Seven.
Here also you'll have only one formula. Here you'll not have seven formulas, only one formula, that xy formula. Third formula what we had written. N sigma ty, instead of xy, minus, instead of sigma x, sigma t into sigma y, upon, instead of n sigma x square, t square, n sigma t square, and minus sigma t whole square. Only one formula throughout the chapter. Every question we will solve by this formula only. Any confusions? All are clear? And a equals to y bar minus b t bar. Earlier it was y bar minus b x bar. Now it will become y bar minus b
t bar.
So exactly same. Any confusions? And that is the reason I am taking this chapter after regression immediately. I don't want to have time gap, because both are exactly same. Exercise 4.2. Question number 4. I'm doing question 4 on the board. 3 we will do it together, 1 and 2 you'll try on your own. And remaining 9 questions will be your homework. Syllabus. So, as I said, today we will finish this topic. That is, this least squares method. Page 172, you have exercise 4.2. And on page 173, you have question number 4. Look at that and understand what all things are asked. The average age of women in years at the time of marriage obtained from the data of different census survey in India are given in the following table. Fit an equation of linear trend. Alright? Fit an equation of linear trend means you'll find this equation. Y cap equals to A plus B. Further. And then show it on graph. That I'll explain you how to show this equation on the graph. Find the underlying estimate for the value of given variable for the year 2021 using the linear equation. So three things are asked in the question. First we have to find equation. Repeat, first we have to find
equation.
Second, we have to show that equation on the graph paper. And third, we have to find estimate of 2021. Okay, equation, we have to show that equation on the graph and estimate of year 2021. Now, how to do that? Understand it? First question, I'm explaining it to you thoroughly. Then second, you'll come along with me. What are the years and average age? Years, average age of women will be denoted as Y. Understand it. First, as we denoted T yesterday, we'll be finding that. Okay? Understand the space first, what you're looking at. Now, regression chapter, we used to obtain 2 workings or 3 workings? Correlation 3, but regression only 2. If coefficient of determination was not asked, 2 workings. Which 2?
X square
and X y. Here, X is to be replaced with
T.
So, T square and T y. Only 2 workings are required. And we have to obtain one more thing, which is trend values. Why we have to obtain this? Because graph is asked. I'll explain you at the end how will we get graph from that. But if graph is asked, then what one more thing you'll obtain?
Trend
values. What is that trend values also? I'll explain at the end. So these are the workings we require. Okay. Now T as we did yesterday, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right on. Any confusion so far? 1971 is the first year, 81 is the second year, 91 is the third year, 2001 is the fourth year, and 11 is the fifth year. Shall I proceed further? Now this working we have studied in the last chapter. So T square, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, 5 square. Any conclusions? And TY, so product of this Y and T, 17.7 into 1, 17.7, 18.7 into 2, 37.4, 19.3 into 3, 57.9, 20.2 into 4, 80.8. And 22.2 into 5, 111. Any confusion in that? Print values at the end, that will remain blank right now. And why we are finding trend values? Graph is us. If graph is us, you have to find trend values. Okay, either trend values will be directly asked or graph will be asked. If graph is asked, then trend values first are required. Total of all will be required. This is 15, 55. 304.8. Raise your hand who is still writing up till here. Shall I proceed further? Everyone has completed. Now, what is the very first? What are the very first two things we used to find in regression chapter? X bar and Y bar. So here what will we find?
T bar
and Y bar. Now T bar equals to sigma T upon N. 15 divided by 5 observations are there. So 3. Y bar equals to sigma Y upon N. 98.1 divided by 5, 19.62. This is the first thing we do as we use to do in regression. X bar, Y bar, here T bar and Y bar. Any confusion so far? Who else is writing it? Now, equation. So like we used to write the statements and solution for regression same way. Equation of trend line is given by y cap equals to a plus bt. Okay, where b equals to n sigma ty minus sigma t into sigma y upon n sigma t square minus sigma t whole square. Raise your hand who did not understand up till here. Raise your hand who is still writing up till here. Shall I proceed? Now, n is 5, total observations in the question are 5. See here, ty is 304.8. Okay, sigma ty 304.8 minus. See here, sigma t 15 into sigma y 98.1. Upon 5 is in, see here sigma t square 55 minus again sigma t means 15 whole square. Any doubts in that? 1524? 5 into 304.8, 1524. Minus 15 into 98.1,
1475.
7.5. Any confusions? 275?
Yes.
Minus 225?
Yes.
5 into 55, 275 and 15 square is 225. So 52.5 upon 51.05. 52.5 divided by 50 b is 1.05. What does this indicate?
Yearly.
10 yearly. Not yearly. Gap is?
Decade.
Yearly when it is 71, 72, 73, 74. But here 71, 81. So every 10 years, the value of y is changing by 1 point. Every 10 years, the age of women for marriage is increasing by 1.05 years. Is everyone clear with this? So that shows the literacy increasing in the country indirectly. And A equals to Y bar minus B T bar. Exactly same format of solving the questions. Y bar, here it is 19.62, okay, minus B is 1.05. Okay, see here B we obtained 1.05 and into T bar is 3. 19.62 minus 3.15. 16.47. Any confusion so far? Raise your hand who did not understand this. Now we will rewrite the equation again as we used to do in regression. So therefore, equation of trend line is y cap equals to a plus bt. That is y cap equals to what did you get? A 16.47 plus what did we get? B 1.05 t. This is the first answer we obtained, and you obtained it in all the questions. Equation will be required in all the questions. Any doubts on that? Any confusion so far? Now understand it carefully. You are asked estimate of 2021. How to find that? Understand it. Raise your hand who is still writing up till here. Now see here. In 1971, the value of t is 81, 91, 2001, 11, 21. In 2021, what would be the value of t? 6. In 2011, it is 5. So after that next decade, 2021, what will be the value of t? 6. We will substitute t as 6. And get the estimate of 2021 as we studied regression also. But for 2021, what is the value of t you will substitute?
6.
Raise your hand who did not understand this. 6 for t. All of you are clear? Turn up for 2021. T is equal to 6. Okay? Therefore, y cap 16.47 plus 1.05 into 6, 16.47 plus 6.3, 22.77, means by the year 2021, the average age of women at the time of marriage will go to 22.77. Did all of you understand this, Jitay? By the time of your marriage, the women's age for the marriage will be 2.77. So, let us know that. Thus, the estimate of average age of women at the time of marriage in 2021 will be 22.77 years. Any confusions?
No.
Now graph we have to show. For that first we have to find this. How to find this trend values, understand it. Okay. First long cut then short cut. So first actual concept how to find this. Write the equation again. 16.47 plus 1.05 t. How do we get this trend values? In t, we will put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We will get the trend values. In t, if you substitute 1, you will get the trend value of 1971. In t, if you substitute, you will get the value of 1981 and so on. So do it. 1.05 into 1 plus 16.47, 17.52. Raise your hand who is not able to understand how to find this. Now what do we have to substitute in t?
2.
So do 1.05 into 2 plus 16.47. 18.57? Now do 1.05 into 3 plus 16.47.
9.02.
Able to understand or not? Now do 1.05 into 4 plus 16.47. 20.67. And the last one do 1.05 into 5 plus 16.47.
21.72.
This is the actual concept. Got it? Now shortcut. First trend value, find it. 1.05 into 1 plus 16.47. Now what did I tell you is the meaning of B? Here 10 yearly change in value of Y. So keep on adding 1.05. Do it. 17.52 plus 1.05. 18.57 plus 1.05. 19.62 plus 1.05. 20.67 plus 1.05. 21.7. Understood the shortcut? Find the first value of trend. After that, keep on adding. If it is positive. If it is negative, keep on subtracting. If it is minus 1.05, then here also it would become minus 1.05 into 1. And you would do 16.47 minus 1.05. And then keep on subtracting 1.05 if it is negative. And if it is positive, keep on adding. Understood this trend value or not? Now what is the meaning of this trend value? Yesterday we studied four components. First, this is that component. Out of 17.7, 17.52 is because of remaining 0.18 is because of seasonal fluctuation, cyclical fluctuation, and random fluctuation. 18.7, out of that, 18.57 is because of trend, remaining 0.13 is due to the remaining three components. Out of 19.3, 19.62 is because of trend, and minus 0.32 is because of seasonal, cyclical, and yesterday we had seen that negative also. I told you negative is also possible. Trend means long-term changes. In the exams, if they ask you, find short-term fluctuations. Which fluctuations? One more column you'll make. Short-term fluctuations. 17.7 minus 17.5. These are long term, remaining are
short term.
Like we used to do error. Here we used to find y cap. Here also you are finding y cap. And then error y minus. Same way, short term fluctuations y minus. If that is asked. Any confusions? Now why we have obtained this? You are asked to show it on graph. Original series will show on the graph. And then yesterday, how did you get the trend line? Randomly we had drawn a line passing through all the points. Now you will not do that. You will plot these points on the graph. And when you join these points, you will get your best trend line. It should be same for all. Okay, this we will plot for the original series. And then instead of directly making a line, what will you do? These values also you will plot on the graph and join them with a straight line. You will get a trend line. That will be the best trend line possible. So let us make the graph. In exams, you must get the graph paper if such a question is asked. Okay? Y-axis, x-axis. Now listen here. What is the lowest value out of these all? Because these all we have to plot.
17.52.
17.52 is the lowest. So let's start with 17. Which is the highest out of these all?
23.
We'll go up to 23. 1 centimeter, 1 unit. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. We'll write the values from 17 to 23. Is everyone clear with this? So on x-axis we will show time t. On y-axis we will show average age of women. In bracket y. Time 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here you directly start from 17, so what will you do? Break the line in that Z kind of sign. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, up to 23. Scale on x-axis. 1 centimeter equals to 10 years. The gap is of 10 years, right? And on y-axis, 1 centimeter equals to 1 year. That is also age of women. Where we are taking 1 centimeter as 1 year's gap only. Write it down fast. Values. Now, first we will plot the original values. See here, when t is 1, 17.7. Now see here, 17.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So at 1 mark it at 17.7. Yesterday we did that, right? What is the next one? So between 18 and 19, 18.5, 18.6, 18.7. After 19, 19.1, 2, 3. 20.2 after 20, 20.1, 20.2. 22.2 after 22, 22.1, 22.2. And as I told you in the beginning, today here also you'll join them with the scale. So you'll get this. Join each of them with scale, 2 points. This is original series. Any confusion? Raise your hand who is still plotting the original series. Shall I explain the trend line now? Yesterday, how did we get the trend line? You randomly made a line that you will not do now. Now we'll plot these points. These points means approximately 17.5, 18.6. 19.6, 20.7, 21.7, approximately for these points. 17.5. Do you get and are able to see this black dotted point? Then 18.6. Then 19.6. Then 20.7 and 21.7. If you join them with straight line, you'll get a straight line here. You should not get it curve form. Join them with straight line, you'll get the trend line. You'll always get it a straight line. And if you do it on graph paper, perfectly straight line, you'll always get it. So here you'll show that circled one is original series and straight one is trend line. So did everyone understand this or not? Any confusions? So one more question, we'll do it together. And one, two questions you'll try on your own. Look at question 3. Anyone who did not understand this graphical part? So if graph is asked, what is necessary before that? Trend values. Graph is asked means first you have to find the trend values. Shall I take up the third question? Everyone has done it. Look at it. The number of two-wheelers registered in thousands. So in thousands means same way when we write the conclusions, we'll write in words in thousands. In a city in different years is as follows. Using the method of fitting linear equation, use the method of fitting linear equation to this data to obtain the and then estimates for the number of vehicles registered in the year like 2016-2017. Two estimates are asked, 2016 as well as 17. Also find the underlying trend values, means this graph is not asked, but trend values are directly asked. Got it everyone? So one step less in this question. We will find up till trend values. Write the years and number of vehicles. even write the values of ELS and Y in confusion so far. Okay, what next?
Sir, D.
Yes. Yes, silence everyone. First we'll obtain the value of T, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Gina, next.
T square.
T square.
1, 4, 6.
9. 3 square is 9.
16.
25. 36. Correct. Vrun, what next?
TY.
69 into 169 is 75 into 2 150 246 364 505 and 690. Did everyone understand this?
Yes.
Correct. Totals?
533 21 91 2024.
Raise your hand who is still writing up till here, and do raise your hand if you are still writing, otherwise we will proceed further. Anyone still writing up till here, raise your hand. Sumana, completed everyone? Yashvi, what next?
T bar.
No formula. Sigma T upon N. Keep silence everyone in the class, don't talk in between. Further. Sigma Y upon N, 533 upon 6. Anyone having any doubt on this? Drew, further. Equation of trend line is given by y cap is equal to a plus bt. Further?
B is equal to n sigma ty minus sigma t sigma y upon n sigma t square minus sigma t over square.
Are you all clear of this? Why Renuka is absent? Out of?
India.
Swara, next.
Six.
And TY is 2024.
Minus 21.
2024. Minus sigma T is 21. Neil and Devani, don't talk in between. Sigma Y is
533.
Upon 6 into 91. Again, N is 6 into sigma T square 91.
Into 21.
Minus sigma T, that is 21 whole square. Any confusions? Then, Ishan.
Well,
12,144 minus 11,193. 546. Is it 444? 441. Are you all clear with this? Then,
Khushi. 951 divided by 105. 9.06.
What does this indicate?
Year.
Now here it indicates yearly because 10, 11, 12, 13, they are 1 year gap only. So yearly change in the value of y is 9.06. Any conclusions? Then what next?
A is equal to
y bar minus b t bar.
88.83
minus 9.06 into 3.5. Anyone having any doubt on this? All are clear up till here? Then, Disha?
Equation of...
Divya ji, don't talk in between. Therefore, equation of...
Trend line is...
Y cap equals to A plus BT.
57.12 plus
9.06T. This is one answer which we have obtained. Did you all understand this? Aryan, what next? No, before that, estimates are asked, two estimates. What to do for 2016? Yes, be attentive here, everyone. In 2015, T is 6. So in 2016, what will be the value of T?
7.
So you'll write for 2016, T is equal to 7. Yes, Aryan, further?
57.12.
Therefore, Y cap is... Akanksha and Tejaswini, no talking in between. 57.12
plus 9.06
into 7.
57.12 plus 63.42.
So 120.54. Okay, same way 2017, so now what will be the value of T in 2017?
8.
Anyone who did not understand this 7 and 8 values? Head on for 2017, T is equal to 8. So Y cap 57.12 plus 9.06 into 8. 57.12 plus 72.48. 129.6. Any confusions in this? Raise your hand who is writing still up till here. Thus the estimated number of vehicles in 2016 will be 120.54, and in words write thousands. In words write thousand. As you can see in the question, the number of vehicles are expressed in thousands or not. And 2017 will be, should I repeat?
The estimated number of vehicles in 2016 will be 120.54,000. In words, you write 1,000. And 2017 will be 129.6. In words, write 1,000. Okay? Now trend value is asked. Divyajit, first trend value. First of all, about trend value, write down the equation y cap equals to 57.12 plus 9.06 t. Yes, Divyajit, first.
Yes.
56.1. Directly do the addition. Do it everyone. 57.12 plus 9.06, because 9.06 into 1 will be 9.06 only. So 57.12 plus 9.06, 66.18. Now what is the shortcut we'll do for others? Keep on adding 9.06. So 75.24, 83.36, 102.42, 111.48. So all the points in the question are clear to everyone. I'll discuss question 1 and 2 and you'll solve them on your own, then you can leave. Look at question 1 and 2, understand them. Who is not clear with trend values part? So what question I took up in the class 4, that included everything up till graph. There is a maximum things that will be asked in the question. Okay, here graph was not asked. Now see the two questions, even trend values are not asked. The information about the death rate of a state in different years is given in the following table. Fit a linear equation to find trend and hence and then estimate the death rate for the year ending 2017. But here only estimate is asked, trend value is not asked. Suppose 2009 you will take TS1. Then 2010, 2, 11,
3,
12,
4,
13,
5,
14,
6,
15,
7,
16,
8, 8,
17,
9.
2017 means what will you substitute T in that?
9.
Raise your hand, who is not clear? Kushali? Understood that? 2009 you will take T as 1, 10 you will take as 2, then 11,
3,
then 12, 4 then 13, 5 then 14, 6 then 15, 7 then 16 would be 8, 17 would be 9. You are asked estimate for 2017. So in 2017 you will take the value of T as 9 to substitute it. Did you understand this? So only estimate is asked, means you find the equation and estimate. That's it. Trend value is not asked. Question 2. The data about cost inflation index declared by the central government are as follows. The year 1981 to 82 is the base for this index. Find the LN estimate of this index for the year LN 15 to 16 by fitting the linear equation to this data. 15 to 16 is immediately next to 14 to 15. So immediate next value you will take. Start solving both the questions. Only estimates are asked, trend values also not asked. Start solving them. Thank you.
9 questions are your homework for Monday. So least squares method is over today. All of you are clear with that? And we did not practice much today. Linear regression also we have been doing the same only. 4 illustrations, 2 exercise questions, exercise for section E and 3 section F questions. Total 9. Thank you.